The Stanley Parable is a meta-commentary on the nature of freedom and choice and video games, packaged as a video game, and today I'll be explaining the lore hidden within. The story begins not so differently from the one we're presented with, however, it isn't as sinister as the narration makes it seem. Stanley is an office worker. The narration presents it in a very technical and robotic manner. However, when you really think about it, this just describes regular work life. You arrive to your job when you're told, and you leave when you're told. When you're there, you do what you're instructed to do, when you're instructed to do it, for as long as you're instructed to do it. For example, say you work at a pizza parlor. Your job dictates that whenever an order comes in, you mold the dough for a certain period of time in a certain area of the restaurant for a certain result. However, you and I would just say, you make a pizza when a customer orders one. Examples of hyper-focusing on decisions and their outcomes appear a lot throughout this game, which makes sense. When you break down the nature of choice and freedom, you begin to come to realizations about not really having choice within your life if every choice and its result has already been dictated by someone else. These examples are usually brought about by Stanley's interaction with the narrator. This lets us know that both he and Stanley share the same mentality in regards to freedom and choice. But why would the narrator, of all people, share the same outlook as Stanley? If he's the one in control, if he is the one that predetermined all of this game's outcome.
Did you move the story somewhere or hold on? Why am I asking you? I'm the one who wrote the story.
Because the narrator is Stanley. We're first given a hint of the true nature of the relationship between the narrator and Stanley when the narrator pleads with Stanley to stay in the room with the beautiful lighting.
We would both be so much happier if we just stopped. Oh no. Stay away from those stairs. If you hurt yourself, if you die, the game will reset. We'll lose all of this. Stanley, please, I'm asking you not to take this away from me. I can't go back to what I was before. If you die, we'll both go back.
This lets us know that the narrator is linked to the game as much as Stanley is. We're also given a glimpse into the narrator needing Stanley in this overhead ending.
Is everything okay? Stanley, please, I need you to make a choice. Stanley, this is important. The story needs you. It needs you to make a decision. It cannot exist without you. Do you understand me? This is more important than you can ever know. I need this. The story needs it.
These instances let us know that the narrator and Stanley are one and the same, two halves of the same whole, one being unable to do things without the other. The narrator needing Stanley to move the story forward, and Stanley needing the narrator to create the story that he experiences. By understanding this, it allows us to understand what the game, the Stanley Parable, actually is within the world of the Stanley Parable. It's a game created by Stanley, which exists within his mind. We've already determined that Stanley actually has a regular job and that the story we're given in the beginning is true, just broken down robotically. We also hear the narrator mention how the game we played through is something he created on multiple occasions.
Hold on. Why am I asking you? I'm the one who wrote the story. My story? You've destroyed my work! Why? For what? What did you get out of that? What did you think was so special about seeing the game undone?
How will you write a story without me? You can't do it, you know that.
And if the narrator is Stanley, then that makes him a regular person, not a god or cosmic deity. So he wouldn't be able to just create a reality for us to exist in. He's just making things up in his head.
But in his mind, in his mind, he can go on fantastic adventures. From behind his desk, Stanley dreamed of wild expeditions into the unknown.
During the mostly infinite whole segment, we're shown that Stanley has a very active imagination when he begins to zone out and view the world from different perspectives and realities.
Stanley! Oh good, you're awake. It seems you had sort of dozed off there, drifting away into dreamland.
Knowing this, wouldn't it make sense that Stanley has the capacity to create a game based on his life that exists within his mind, where he's not only the game master, but the game player as well? But what drove him to this? Why did Stanley make this game in the first place? Was it out of pure boredom, or was it to escape the monotony of his everyday life? I think the answer lies somewhere in the middle. The Stanley Parable, it's a meta-commentary on the nature of choice and freedom, and the lack thereof one can feel when they understand that every decision they make has a predetermined outcome. And I think that's what happened to Stanley. He knows that his life and the decisions he makes are mostly predetermined. He knows that more and more he's losing control of the direction that his life is going, so he creates this game. It exists solely within his mind and is created in order to help him cope with that crushing reality. reality. That's why the narrator tries to help Stanley for the most part. He exists as someone with control, trying to help Stanley find some kind of happiness within this world, even though he himself has limited control.
Are you that convinced that I want something bad to happen to you? Why, I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you, to show you something beautiful. I wonder if he's happy with his choice, and if he's learned the heavy cost that comes with it. He'll understand soon what I was trying to tell him. He needs me. Someone who will wrap everything up at the end, to make sense out of the chaos and the fear and the confusion. That's who I am. That is what I mean to this world. Oh, yes. Yes, I'll be back. There's no other way.
The Stanley character is the part of him that wishes to rebel against not having control. That's why he has the ability to go off script and choose his own ending. But ultimately, those endings are predetermined and scripted, just like how Stanley feels about his own life. And that's why this game doesn't have a canon ending. Life doesn't have a canon ending. You're free to choose whatever path you want. Once you reach the end of that path, life continues on. Sometimes it feels as if you're repeating the same plot lines. That's why we experience things like deja vu. And this fits within the meta commentary the developers tried to get across with this game. So then, what is the story of the Stanley Parable? Stanley, a regular office worker, has an existential crisis after he realizes that he has no real freedom within his life. In order to cope, he creates a game within his mind that helps him come to terms with the way he feels. In this game, he's able to decide what happens, either as the player character or as the narrator. Sometimes he has fun and is able to enjoy himself, like in the confusion ending. Other times, he's battling against his own thoughts of powerlessness, like in the jumping off the stairs ending.
I just wanted us to get along. But I guess that was too much to ask. It looks like you wanted to make a choice after all. Well, this one is yours.
And just like the game, this video has no ending. It's just over when it's over.